With the implementation of the CineRender engine into ArchiCAD, you may find working with surface materials a whole new world. Understanding the basic principles of channels and their interaction is a real challenge in the beginning. Becoming familiar with shaders is the next level. In this clip, we'll take a quick look at a few of them and examine how they work. Let's see how this tile texture is built up. In the color channel, we have a layer that enables us to stack various shaders or even bitmap images on top of each other. When setting up your own material, you can create a layer from the following menu. Within this layer, there's a brick shader at the bottom which has the most important role. It defines the base color and the structure of the tile. With scale, you can change the number of the tiles. The preview window updates automatically when changing any available parameter. With brick width and height values, the vertical and horizontal size of the tiles can be defined. It's also possible to shift the rows. Here we can change the base, and the gap color. These are the most important parameters, but as you can see, the brick shader is really feature-rich, with almost endless possibilities. Feel free to experiment with other available options. The preview window will always give you instant feedback on any changes made. On top of the brick shader, there are four weathering shaders that help lend a weathered look. Each of these are responsible for one side only: bottom, top, right, and left. And on the top, there's a noise shader that gives an overall noise to the tile. Each of these shaders create one layer on top of each other and are mixed together based on the opacity value and mix mode. In the reflection and bump channels, we'll find the same brick shader with some modest changes.